We have seen credit card operations, then benefit of credit card to the cardholder, benefit of credit card to the merchant, okay. Then the interest of a credit card operation. Okay, so now our next topic is remittances, last topic. Now I think that only for topic is remaining. After that, a bank guarantee, letter of credit, then which one? Depository system. Okay, so next topic is debit card. So everyone know that debit card. Everyone know the debit card. So what is the difference between which one, ATM and debit card? Now you know majority of the ATM card also function as debit card. So if you look at that ATM card, you can see ATM, debit card, debit or shopping card, shopping card. So majority of the ATM card are which one, a debit card only. Okay, in earlier separate only ATM is a pin based card, automatic teller machine used to transact in ATM only. But debit card have more multifunctional card. Okay, so that is which one, a debit card. But now almost majority of the banks are majority of the banks issue that ATM card, there is also function as a debit card. Debit card. Okay, that is debit card. So what do you mean by debit card? What do you mean by debit card? So how we will get a debit card? So whenever we open the bank account, we will get which one, ATM card or a debit card. Okay, so a person can get a debit card by depositing money in a bank. Okay, so with the help of the debit card, we can purchase goods and services. Okay, with the using which one, with the use of a debit card, we can purchase the goods and services. Suppose if you go to the which one, supermarket, you have no which one, cash. So what we can do, we can give, we can present which one, our debit card, our ATM debit card. Okay, then they will give you the POS, point of sale terminal. So with the help of that, the terminal automatically transfer money from our account to the seller's account. Okay, that is about which one, debit card. Okay, so debit can be debit card can be used to withdraw money from the ATM. Okay, withdraw money from the ATM, which one, with the help of the with the help of the debit card. Okay, so whenever we make a transactions, they immediately they will debit amount from our account. Okay, then one more facility should also offer cash back facility to customer. They also offer cash back facilities. Cash back facilities. What do you mean by cash back facilities? Here, the customer can withdraw cash along with their purchase. For example, suppose if you go to the supermarket, so with the help of the card, we can purchase goods. Then you want cash, ready cash. Okay. So with the help of that, they will take, they will, suppose 2000 is the amount of purchase. So we want 2000 ready cash. Cardholder want 2000 ready cash. So what we'll do, they will give, they used to give the amount. So then they will make which one, for a terminal amount will be 4000. So 2000 they will give ready cash. Normally we used to petrol pump, majority of the people used to do, I also used to do like this, which one, cash back facilities. Okay, then no need to go to ATM, they will give the amount. they will deduct the amount from our bank account through a debit card, but we will get cashback facilities. You have no time to go to ATM. So in this case, we can use the debit card as a cashback facilities. Okay, that is about a debit card. So it is also known as bank card. It's a plastic money card that provide the card holder electronic access to his or her bank account at a financial institution.
Some cards known as
stored value with which a payment is made, while most relay a message to the card holder bank to withdraw money from a payer's designated bank account. The card where accepted can be used instead of cash and making purchases. After making the transaction, immediately we will get a message, okay, from the bank account. Is there, your amount is debited with rupees 2000 rupees, okay, or 3000 rupees. That is which one? Debit card. So if anyone know the about the debit card, ATM. So that is also functioning as a debit card. Okay, so you can look at that your parents' ATM. You can see that debit card or shopping card. Okay, so that is which one now? Debit card. Next one. Details on the front of a typical debit card. Okay, details on the front of a typical debit card. Everyone, turn on your video. Okay, so details on the front of a typical debit card. So issuing bank logo. We issued that the bank logo, then EMV chip, this one, that will be EMV chip. EMV means Europay, MasterCard and Visa. That only represent that one. Okay, EMV, Europay, MasterCard, Visa card. Okay, this one, that is which one? Visa. Okay, MasterCard and Visa means a card with a smart chip. This one is EMV chip. Next one, card brand logo, American Express, Master, Visa, Discover. That is card brand logo. Next one, magnetic strip, this one, that is magnetic strip. Okay, magnetic strip. Then hologram. Okay, so hologram for what purpose? Hologram is used to do payment processing in a more secure manner. For that, hologram is the inbuilt setup to do payment processing in a secure manner. For that purpose only, hologram. Then magnetic strip, it is a swipe card capable of storing data. It's capable of storing data. That no need to study anything, only the details you have to study. Okay. Then reverse side, what are the items are there? So issuing bank logo, EMV chip, hologram, card number, card brand logo, expiration date, card holder's name, details on the reverse side of a typical debit card, magnetic strip, signature strip, you can see. Okay, so the back, we can see that the signature. Signature strip, then signature strip, card security code. The reverse side you can see CVV card security code you can see. Okay, so these are the content. The front of typical debit card, issuing bank logo, EMV chip, hologram, card number, card brand logo, expiration date, card holder's name, details on the reverse side of a typical debit card, signature strip, magnetic strip, card security code. So these are the details we can see in the debit card. Next, how debit card stumbles. This only, they are specifying that only. Suppose if you are making that which an online, online purchase using debit card, how it works. So here it is specified that whenever you are making the transaction through online, you have to enter the PIN number. For which one? For security only, you have to enter the PIN number or the identification system. So then only we can buy. Otherwise, anyone can buy that this transaction, buy the goods with the help of our debit card. So it is secured only. It is very secured only. For that, we have to enter the PIN number. Okay. So PIN number we have to enter. Then only we can purchase the goods with the help of the debit card. Then for a merchant, what they have to do? They have to. They need which one for a debit card purpose? They need which device? They need a point of sale, and sometimes they need a PIN pad. PIN pad means it is an electronic device. Electronic device used in debit or credit card transaction to accept and encrypt the cardholder's personal identification number. Encrypt means convert into code to prevent the unauthorized access. So we can tell that only large number of transactions. Okay, we can make a large payment transaction. So we can make with the use of only debit card. It is secured because we have to use secure purpose. We are using the PIN number for the identification system. Then only we can make the transaction. Next one. Advantages of debit card and the disadvantages of debit card. Okay, so next, advantages of a debit card. So you can do more push in these areas. Okay, so if you know the heading points. Okay, advantages of a debit card. 1 minute. Okay, so advantages of a debit card: easy to obtain, convenience, safety, readily accepted. So these are the advantages of a debit card. Okay, so first one, easy to obtain. Whenever you open a bank account with any bank, they will issue ATM card. They will issue debit card, ATM. So that is also which one function as a debit card. They will issue, okay? Because for them also it will be easy. Otherwise, majority of the people will come they will come to bank and they will withdraw amount from the bank. So if they issue debit card means for them it will be good. Okay, no risk, they can take risk. So easy to obtain. So whenever every bank, they will issue the debit card. Next one, conveniences. Okay, so suppose if example, if you carry cash means there will be a problem of theft. Someone will take our habitual cash, but here we have no need to carry our cash. Only we have to keep our one card. Okay, that is also less weighted. Okay, so with the help of the card, we can purchase goods and services easily. Okay, so that is convenience. It is easy to use, debit card. Next one, safety. Okay, so safety means the same only, no need to carry cash, check, nothing is there. So safeties are ensured in a debit card. It is more safe only. Okay, so if it is lost also, we have to report the bank. Okay, then they will cancel the transactions. If it is there in upcoming transaction, they will cancel. So safety also there. Next one, readily accepted. Okay, so it is a widely accepted card only. Which one? Debit card. So when you go out of the state, so you can use this card. Okay, debit card. So with the use of this card, we can purchase the things. We can make online transaction. Anything we can do. So it is widely accepted. Okay, it is widely accepted. If it is in Delhi also, Kerala also, no problem. Okay. That is, these are the advantages of a debit card. So if you know the point, then you can easily explain the thing. So easy to obtain, convenience, safety, then readily accepted. Next, disadvantages of a debit card. Disadvantages of a debit card, no grace period, then checkbook balancing. Okay, no grace period. No grace period means here they are not giving any credit facility. Here means whenever we make the transaction, immediately they will debit the amount from our account. Immediately they will debit it. They are not giving any period. Okay, immediately. But if it is in the credit card, means they are giving grace period. 1 month they are giving. So, okay, 1 month they are giving. Here means no grace period. Immediately. At spot, they will deduct amount from our account. Clear? So that is one disadvantage. Next, checkbook balancing. Checkbook balancing. Okay. So suppose if we are using the debit card, means what? We won't check our bank account details after making every transaction. Okay. So the balancing our account will be difficult. So if you record each and every transaction, then no problem. Otherwise, balancing the our bank account details, it will be very difficult. Okay, so we won't look. Most of the people won't look. Some so they will look each and every transactions.
Sir, I don't have any credit card or debit card. So how it is advantage or disadvantage for me?
Okay, next, sir. So that is two disadvantages of debit card, no grace period and balancing. So we won't do such activities. Okay, we'll check our account. After that only we will understand that our balance will be much amount. Okay, so that is one thing. Next one, this difference between credit card and debit card. Last topic only, difference between debit card and credit card. So credit card, you look at that, borrowing money from a bank or financial institutions. Okay, means spending others' money. Okay, that is which one? Credit card. Okay, but debit card, watch, funds taken from the money that you have in your bank account. Means spending your own money. Suppose if you are if you want to make a purchase goods for rupees 10,000, but if you have in your bank account only 5,000, means you can make only 5,000 purchase only. Okay, spending your own money, but with the help of the card, means we can use the limit. Borrowing limit is there, they will specify the limit. With that amount we can borrow. Okay, here means fund taken from the money that you have in your bank account. Next one, need not connected to any bank account. Need not be connected to any bank account. This one, which one? Credit card. So separate card they are issuing. It is not connected to any saving account or bank account, anything. Okay, to get a credit card, no need this one. So, but here means needs checking your account, checking account and saving account. So if you have a saving account, we will get a debit card. So we have to check our account. Which one? It is related to the account only. Okay, if you have amount in that account, then only we can utilize. Next one, pay additional interest drawn on the amount borrowed. So if we pay the balance in a time, no problem. Otherwise, we have to pay interest, additional interest. Here means no interest to be paid, because we are giving amount from our own bank account, our money only we are spending. So for that, no interest to be paid. Next one, limit. limit is there already. I said that the issuing bank, they will specify the limit. Within 1 month, you can purchase this much amount only. On the base of the credit worthiness of the applicant only, they will specify the limit. Here, limit is what? Equal to your account balance or limit. Okay. So your balance is only 100, but you want to purchase which one? 10,000 goods. That it is not possible. Okay. Equals your account balance or limit. Okay. That is about which one? Difference between credit card and debit card. Okay. So these are the things related to remittances. Remittances. Okay. Remittances. So now I taught which one, what do you mean by debit card? So debit card means how they will get the debit card. A person can get the debit card by opening account, by depositing money in the bank account. With the help of the debit card, we can purchase the goods and services. We can withdraw amount from ATM. Then mini debit card, which one also offer cash back facilities to the customer. Okay, next one, details on the debit card. Details on the debit card, issuing bank logo, EMV chip, Europay, MasterCard, Visa, hologram, card number, card brand logo, expiration date, card holder's name, details on the reverse side of a typical debit card, magnetic strip, a signature strip, card security code. Next one, debit card system work. This is secured. All debit cards are very secure. We can make any large transactions with the help of the debit card. It is safer because we have to enter the PIN number. Okay. So next one, advantages of a debit card: easy to obtain, convenience, safety, readily accepted. Then the disadvantages of a debit card: no grace period. Then a checkbook balancing. Checkbook balancing. Next, the difference between credit and debit card: borrowing money from a bank or finance institutions. Here means fund taken from the money that you have in your bank account. It may not connected to any bank account. Here needs it is connected to saving account. Next one, pay additional interest on the amount borrowed. Here no interest to be paid. Here limits are there. We can purchase goods on the basis of that credit line only. Here equal to your account balance. So our remittance over. Remittance service are over. So you know that remittance services, paper-based, checked, demand draft. Okay. Demand draft, it is payable to the person named in the instrument, DD. Okay, it is safer. Okay, after depositing money only, we will get amount. Next, electronic fund transfer, NEFT, RTGS, NEFT, National Electronic Fund Transfer. Okay, if you have no account, means maximum we can transfer, that is 50,000. RTGS, real time gross settlement system. So minimum amount it is 2 lakh. Okay. Next, cards. We studied which one, credit cards and debit cards. So remittance are over. Okay. So safe custody of variables, locker facilities, then remittances. Over. Next one. So from this chapter, you know, you look at a total 157 pages are there. So out of that 57 pages from first chapter only. Okay. So daily you have to study each topic, then you have to revise each week. You have to revise the entire weekly portions.